In this video, we're going to look at how to find small fractures on MRI. Now, it's difficult on MRI with small fractures, not as easy as CT or even X-ray. But there are some clues we can use to make it a bit easier to make the diagnosis of a small fracture. This video has come from a talk we gave with Hitachi Medical Systems Singapore. We need to also look at how do you find a small fracture, because sometimes you may not have the X-ray available to look at, or they have, you know, there isn't a CT performed. This usually goes from X-ray to MR. So small fractures can be pretty difficult on MR, and you actually may not see the fragment itself. So you have to look for other things that point you towards there being a fracture. And a couple of things we can look at. So the first thing, you focus on the area of edema. The second bit is to look for localized loss of cortex. If we look at this medial tibial plateau first. So if you follow the cortical line, so cortex is dense bone, so it's black. So what you expect to see is a nice black line that is continuous all the way through. In this person who's got a Segond fracture, what we see is a nice black line. Then there's a bit missing. And then here's the black line again. We can't see the fracture fragment very well, but the absence of this black line tells you that there is a fracture there. So with small fractures where you may not see the fragment, this is your clue to there being a fracture, the absence of this black cortical line where in the region where there's edema. Okay, what about another thing? Another thing to look at is to look for a step in the cortex. So here is where the fracture fragment has been slightly displaced from the parent bone. And the pink arrow is pointing to the normal cortex. So we have the normal cortical line. Here's the cortical line above. And then you see that they don't match. There's a gap there between the two of them. So the things that we're really looking for when you're looking for a small Segond fracture is to focus on the area of edema, look for localized loss of cortex, and then also look for a step of the cortex. You may have one, two, or three of these. You don't have to have all of them.